Hi children, in our previous video we had discussed some of the MCQ type questions of the chapter chemical reactions and equations. In this chapter we are going to still continue some of the remaining MCQ type questions. Let us see the question here. Which of the following is not a redox reaction? What is meant by a redox reaction? The reaction in which oxidation and reduction takes place simultaneously were called as the redox reactions. Here we got some options like burning of magnesium ribbon in air, addition of dilute HCl to zinc granules, addition of silver nitrate to sodium chloride, release of energy during respiration. Now let us study each and every option in detail. Burning of magnesium ribbon in air means the magnesium is getting reacted with atmospheric oxygen to form magnesium oxide. Let us see the equation here. It is 2Mg plus O2 gives rise to 2MgO. What is happening for the magnesium? It is gaining oxygen. Hence, we speak it is undergoing the oxidation reaction. Let us check the second one. That is addition of dilute HCl to zinc. In this reaction, we can have the reactants HCl and zinc. What is happening for the reactants? From the HCl, the hydrogen was removed. So, we can speak the loss of hydrogen as the oxidation, and whereas the zinc is gaining the electronegative element that is called chlorine, so it is called oxidation. So it is both undergoing the oxidation and reduction, means it is a redox reaction. We got the option C now, that is addition of silver nitrate to sodium chloride. Do we know the formula of silver nitrate? Yes, AgNO3 to sodium chloride, that is NaCl. Here we need to check the equation of silver nitrate with sodium chloride. We got the equation here. AgNO3 plus NaCl gives rise to AgCl plus NaNO3. There we got a down arrow that is indicating a precipitation reaction. Means it is not undergoing the gain of hydrogen or the loss of oxygen. There is the exchange of ions between the reactants. So we can speak here it is undergoing the process of double displacement reaction. It is not a redox reaction. We got the option here that the question itself, they had a question as which is not a redox reaction. We can speak here this is not a redox reaction. Let us check the option D also, that is release of energy during respiration. During respiration, what happens? The glucose, the food that we had taken, that is the glucose molecules that have broken into small units, they will be reacting with the oxygen that we are respiring to form the carbon dioxide, water, and they release the energy. Do you find in the reactant side, that is C6H12O6, there the carbon is especially gaining oxygen, means can we could speak it is undergoing oxidation, as well as from that C6H12O6 hydrogens are removed, means it is undergoing reduction. You can also observe the hydrogen especially it is gaining oxygen. So in this reaction we can observe there is an oxidation reaction and there is a reduction reaction. Overall, this is an redox reaction. So, which is not a redox reaction means we can speak the silver nitrate when added by sodium chloride. It is just a double displacement reaction and is also precipitation reaction, but not an redox reaction. So, we can conclude the question. That is, which of the following is not a redox reaction means? The option C is not a redox reaction. Let us check the second question now. Aluminium reacts with copper chloride to give aluminium chloride. The balanced equation for this reaction is, very good. Whenever any balanced equation is given, you need not want to worry for anything. The first and foremost thing is, you must know the valences of the ions. Do you know the 9th standard crisscross topic, crisscross method? Yes, in that we had learned about the valences of the ions. Here, what is the reactant given? Aluminium reacts with copper chloride. Generally, the copper chloride, in that the copper will be showing a plus 2 oxidation state. That is Cu2 plus oxidation state. Chloride, we know, a minus 1 oxidation state. But what is the oxidation state of aluminium? Basically, aluminium will show a plus 3 oxidation state. That is 3 plus, we can say, majorly. Now, in the end product, it is saying aluminium chloride is formed. We need to give a balanced equation here. Let us see the balanced equation for this reaction. Aluminium bearing an 3 plus charge is now going to form a compound with chloride that is having a minus 1 charge. So we need to crisscross their valences. Once we start crisscrossing their valences, what is the compound formed here? AlCl3, aluminium chloride. In the aluminium chloride, what is the number of chlorines bonded with aluminium? We can find there are 3 chlorines bonded with aluminium. Means for a single aluminium, how many chlorines will be combined? 3 chlorines will be combined. Now the question is, copper chloride, we had already discussed that in the copper chloride, each copper will be combining with 2 of the chlorines. Each copper will be combining with 2 of the chlorines. Because copper chloride, in that copper is going to show a plus 2 oxidation state. Copper is going to show a plus 2 oxidation state. Now, in that criteria, we need to remember Al plus CuCl2 is the basic equation. Now, we got many options. Al plus CuCl2 is the basic background equation. Gives rise to AlCl3 plus 3Cu is the products given in the option A. But observe, what is a balanced chemical equation? The number of reactants must be equal to the number of products. Here, on the reactant side, there is only one aluminium and there is one copper and 2 chlorines. But in the product side, there is one aluminium, but chlorines are 3 and copper is also 3. Is it a balanced equation? No. Now let us check with the option B. We had already discussed for the crisscross method, one aluminium needs how many chlorines, children? 3 chlorines. And on the reactant side, the copper chloride, the copper will be The copper will be combining with 2 chlorines. Now, you check the second option. How it was given? 2Al plus 3ClCl2. Reactant side, we got 2 aluminiums and the number of moles of copper chloride are 3. In the product side, you can observe 2AlCl3. We had already discussed one aluminium will combine with 3 chlorines. In this case, how many aluminiums we had in the reactant side? 2 aluminiums we had. So, 1 aluminium combines with 3 chlorines. 2 aluminiums will combine with 6 chlorines. What the number of chlorines were balanced on the product side? Yes, you can check. 2AlCl3 means the chlorines are, 3 2s are 6 we got. So, reactant side aluminium and the chlorines are balanced. Now, how many coppers are left over? We had 3 coppers in the reactants and in the products also we had 3 coppers. Now, can we could see this may be the balanced equation. But let us check the option C also at Y. 3Al plus 2CuCl2. Here on the reactant side we had 3 aluminiums and 4 chlorines totally. But in the product side, 3AlCl3. chlorines are 6. In the reactant side, we had only 4 chlorines, but in the product side, we got 6 chlorines. So this is also not a balanced equation. So option 4 at last, Al plus 3 CaCl2 gives rise to. What is the product we got here? AlCl3. How many AlCl3 we got? Only 1 mole of AlCl3. What does this indicate for us? This is indicating that chlorines on the reactant side we had 6, but on the product side there are only 3. By this, what can we conclude? Can we conclude that it is also not a balanced equation? Then what is the exact balanced equation? We can say the exact balanced equation is only the option number B. That is 2Al plus 3CuCl2 gives rise to 2AlCl3 plus 3Cu. So let us see the next question here. Raju's silver ring gradually turned black due to the formation of the following layer on it. A person named Raju was mentioned here. He got a silver ring. It turned black. They already mentioned to what color did it turn to. Why did it, or what is the layer formed over the silver is the question here. Do you remember the topic called corrosion that we had already discussed? Yes, the metals react with the gases present around them. Like the iron reacts with the moisture to form iron oxide. The brown color copper develops a green coating over it, that is called copper carbonate. And also the silver articles reacts with atmospheric silver sulfur to form silver sulfide, which is a black colored compound. So here, why did the Raju silver ring turn to black? Because we can explain that the silver reacts with the sulfur present in the air and it forms a coating of silver sulfide around it. Hence, it turns to black in color. So what is our correct option now? Can you say here? The options are like silver oxide, silver nitrate, silver sulfide, silver sulfate. See here, silver sulfide means Ag2S. Silver sulfate means AgSO4. Here silver reacts with atmospheric sulfur to form only silver sulfide. So that is the correct answer. Let us take up the next question. Galvanization is the process in which, do you remember children, what is meant by the word galvanization? Did we discuss any time? Yes, we do have discussed. Whenever the iron articles are getting rusting, we can prevent them from applying, from the rusting or the corrosion, by applying paint, grease, oiling, galvanization, chrome plating, and also alloying. These are the methods that we had used to prevent the iron articles from getting rusting. Among them, there we had discussed the iron in the metal reactive series. It was placed somewhere that is below to zinc. When we are getting the rusting of iron, we can coat the iron with a highly reactive metal like zinc, so that the zinc will form a protective layer over the iron, and the zinc will undergo the process of corrosion when it prevents the iron from undergoing rusting. So this is what we call the sacrificial method of preventing one metal by another metal. Zinc is sacrificing itself to prevent the iron from undergoing the corrosion. So the process of coating zinc over iron, it is what we have learned as the galvanization. Let us see the concept here. There is a prevention of corrosion. Rusting of iron can be prevented by painting, oiling, greasing, galvanizing, chrome plating, anodizing, or making alloys. There we have discussed about the galvanization as a method of protecting steel and iron from rusting by coating them with a thin layer of zinc. So what is the answer we can expect now? Caramelization means zinc coating is given to the iron. So it is not the remaining copper coating or the zinc over copper or aluminium over iron. It is just coating zinc over iron. Now some of the question will be, why can't we coat aluminium over the iron? Here we can coat aluminium over the iron, but it is highly reactive than the zinc. So it will undergo more corrosion than the zinc. So it is coated, zinc is coated, which is less reactive than aluminium to prevent the iron from undergoing corrosion. So the galvanization is the process of coating zinc over iron. Let us see the question number 5 here. In this chemical reaction represented by the figure, the color of the precipitate formed is very good. They had taken one beaker. In the beaker, they had taken the barium chloride solution. Generally, barium chloride will be colorless solution. And they had taken another test tube. In that, they had taken sodium sulfate solution. Do you know what is the color of sodium sulfate solution, children? Yes, it is colorless. But when the sodium sulfate is added to barium chloride, what type of chemical reaction will happen here? Do you remember any type of chemical reaction, and can you could balance the equation here? Yes, let us balance the equation here. We already learnt about sodium sulfate when reacted with barium chloride. It is forming the barium sulfate precipitate and also sodium chloride. The precipitate is the insoluble substance that settles at the bottom of the test tube, hence it is written as the down arrow. So what is the color of the precipitate here especially? The color of the precipitate in this reaction is the white color precipitate that we had learnt in the NCERT textbook. So what are the given options now? Once we can check, the options are like red, black and yellow. So we had given the answer the white. In this case, sodium sulfate when added with barium chloride, we got a white colored precipitate of barium sulfate. Let us check the next question. That is, statements are mentioned here. Two statements, statement A and statement B. An alloy is a homogeneous mixture of two or more metals. And statement B, an alloy is a homogeneous mixture of metal or non-metal. Let us see what are the points are given here. Options. Statement A and B are correct. Statement A is correct, but B is incorrect. C, and option C, statement A and B are both incorrect. In the option D, statement A is incorrect and B is correct. Before marking any of the option, just recall the main concept. The iron that we had chosen, the corrosion process, it can be prevented by the process of alloying. We got this topic in the grade 9 standard also. What is meant by the process of alloying? Alloying is the process in which a metal is added by what and what. Before we see that, let us take some explanation. Basically, the pure iron is not having high strength. So it is mixed with a very less amount of carbon that increases the strength of the iron, and now it is called as the steel. So what is meant by the steel? Steel means the iron is combined with very less percentage of carbon that increases the strength of the iron. Now iron is a metal, whereas carbon is the non-metal. What had we mixed for the iron? We mixed the metal with a non-metal carbon to increase the strength. So here we mixed a metal with a non-metal, and it is the process of alloying we call. But let us see, the utensils that we use in the home, are they getting rusted? No, they will not be rusted, because they are given with the tag stainless steel. What is meant by steel? We had already discussed the combination of iron with carbon is called as the steel. Then what is stainless steel? Again, for this steel, the components nickel and chromium will be added in a particular ratio. So stainless steel is the composition which there will be iron, nickel, chromium and also carbon. These four together we can say they will not make the iron to be rusted. Iron is a metal, nickel is a metal, chromium is a metal, carbon is a non-metal. In this case, for the iron we had added metal and also a non-metal to make it as a stainless steel. So Ken could call the process of alloying is the one in which a metal will be added by a non-metal, or metal can be added with a non-metal or a metal. Let us see the explanation points here. You can note down, that is, the steel is the combination of iron plus carbon, which is a metal and non-metal. In this, the carbon percentage is very less, 0.05%, whereas in the stainless steel, which is a very hard, it's not rust, we have the iron, nickel and also chromium, including the carbon, which is a non-metal also. These two, when we study the main points, we can draw some conclusion. And we need to check here now the our options. Statement A, alloy is an homogeneous mixture of two or more metals. Yes, in the case of stainless steel, we got iron, nickel, chromium. These are all metals only. And statement B, alloy is a mixture of metal with a non-metal. Yes, we got iron with carbon, that is a non-metal. So the statements both are true. A and B are true, that they are correct. So this is the correct answer for us. So what is the purpose of this alloying means? We can say they are very good in improving the property. So what is the correct answer we got? We got the correct answer as the statement A. Now let us see the question. The components used in the manufacturing of surgical instruments. The doctors, when they are operating the surgical with the surgical instruments, what are the surgical instruments made up of? They are made up of stainless steel. We had already got what is the combination of stainless steel. What is the combination of stainless steel? Iron, carbon, nickel and chromium. Which option do you find there? Iron, nickel, chromium and carbon. I hope we got the fourth option. Iron, nickel, chromium and carbon. Let us see the next question here. Choose the correct statement about the given chemical reaction. Very good one. Chemical reaction is given here. This question is asked in the NTSC 2019-20. Now what is the chemical equation given here? 3 moles of manganese dioxide were added by 4 moles of aluminium. They had formed 3 moles of manganese and also 2 moles of aluminium oxide. Along with that, heat was released in the equation. Very good. Once again we are checking the equation. 3MnO2 plus 4Al gives rise to 3Mn plus 2Al2O3 plus heat. Now they had given some statements. In the statement A, reaction is exothermic. Whenever any reaction at the product side, if you had the word heat or light, it is saying it is an exothermic reaction. So do you agree the statement A is a true statement? Yes, we do agree it is an exothermic reaction. And next statement B we are studying. Aluminium is acting as an oxidizing agent. What is meant by this meaning of oxidizing agent? It is the meaning oxidizing agent, the one that makes the another reactant to gain oxygen. Oxidizing agent is the one that makes the another reactant to gain oxygen. But here in the above reaction, please check the reactant side. We got 3MnO2 plus 4Al gives rise to 3Mn plus 2Al2O3. Is aluminium making the manganese to gain oxygen or lose oxygen? Aluminium is not making the manganese to gain oxygen, but it is making to lose the oxygen. So we cannot call the aluminium as an oxidizing agent now, but we need to call it as an reducing agent. So what is a reducing agent? It is the one which makes the reactant, another reactant, to lose the oxygen. Here aluminium is making the manganese dioxide to lose the oxygen. hence it is an reducing agent but not an oxidizing agent. So we say the statement B is a false statement. MnO2 is getting reduced. The statement C, they say MnO2 is getting reduced. What is meant by reduction? Addition of oxygen, removal of addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen. Here MnO2 was converted into Mn. MnO2 was converted into Mn. So MnO2 when converted to Mn, it lost the oxygen. Loss of oxygen is called reduction. Gain of hydrogen is called reduction. But here there are no hydrogens to be mentioned. We got only oxygens. So MnO2 has lost oxygens. It is undergoing getting reduced. So we say the statement C is also a true statement. Al is more reactive than manganese. Again we need to recall our metal reactive series. In our metal reactive series, we can get the point that aluminium, as it is highly reactive than manganese, then only it can displace the manganese from its salt solution. So in this case, the equation it is saying aluminium displaced manganese. When it can happen? It can happen when the aluminium is highly reactive than manganese, only the reaction can be possible. So aluminium is highly reactive than manganese. So which are the correct options? Option 1, A, C and D are correct, they mention. Which one is the false? Then we already got aluminium is a reducing agent here but not an oxidizing agent. So I agree with the option 1 as the true statement. You can study the explanation part here. In the above equation, heat is released, so it's an exothermic reaction, and statement A is correct. But aluminium is gaining oxygen and making MnO2 lose the oxygen. Hence, aluminium is acting as a reducing agent, but not the oxidizing agent. MnO2 is losing oxygen, hence it is getting reduced. Hence, statement C is correct. In the metal reactive series, we know aluminium is more reactive than manganese. Hence, aluminium is can displace to manganese. So the option statement D is also correct. Hence, we have only the correct option as the first option. Let us check the next question. This was also question in the NTSC 2019 and 20 question paper. Assertion and reasoning type question is this one. Silver articles become black after some time when exposed to air. In this video only we got about the same type of question. Silver articles become black after some time when exposed to the air. Okay. Reasoning. It reacts with oxygen to form a coating of silver oxide. Do the silver gets coated with oxide or sulfide? Yes, during corrosion the silver articles become black because they will be coated by the sulfide, that is the reacting with atmospheric sulfur. So assertion is a true statement only. Silver articles are getting black, but the reasoning is not the correct explanation for assertion. Let us see here the points. Silver articles become black after some time when exposed to air. This is a process of corrosion. This is because it reacts with sulfur in the air to form a coating of silver sulfide, but not it is forming a silver oxide. So let us say the option A. A and R are correct. Assertion is correct, but reasoning is an incorrect. Let us see this option B. A and R are correct. Here assertion is correct but reasoning is false. We cannot agree here. See the option C. A is true as silver articles are becoming black, and reasoning, it is not the correct reasoning because silver is reacting with sulfur to form the silver sulfide. So what is the correct answer we can give? We can give the correct answer as the C, because when you see in the option D, both A and A are false. No, we have the only option C. Okay children, we had concluded our chapter with all these MCQ type questions. Thank you.